Hey everybody, this is Vinny with ExcelDistanceCalculators.com, home of some of the most useful and nifty Excel tools out there. I can't believe I used the word nifty, but hadn't heard that word in a long time. Like every week, my goal is to provide a Excel tool that will make your life just a little bit easier, automate some part of your business process, and give you some additional free time, free up some of your time. The purpose of this tool, which is the Travel Reimbursement Calculator in Excel, it does exactly what the name suggests that it does. It is a travel reimbursement tool that will calculate your reimbursement for your employees or for your contractors or whoever you reimburse for travel. It will make that process extremely easy. Let me kind of show you how it works, but before I do that, a couple of things about my tools. All of my tools are built in Excel. For those of us who, that haven't seen some of my videos before, all of my tools are built in Excel. There's nothing to install. You will need Google Maps API. We use Google Maps API to generate those distances, so you'll need that. We've got a separate video on that in the description on how to set up that API key. It's free of charge to set up, and you don't get charged for anything above 40,000 or below 40,000 calculations. After that, I believe Google charges you $5 per thousand, but for a lot of my clients, they never really reach that 40,000 calculations per month. So let me kind of show you how it works. So in this, we have the settings tab and the trips tab. On the trips tab, we set up our trips that we need reimbursement for. The columns in orange are the columns that we need to enter, and the columns in blue are the columns that the tool will automatically generate. In this case, I've added a trip date and trip purpose. Really, those are not required. Those are just mostly for information, for your information, or for the employee's information. We do require the from and the to address, because those are the addresses that the tool will use to calculate the driving distance. And again, this is driving distance we pull from Google Maps. It is not as the crow flies, right? So this would be the miles that the employee had to drive. In addition to that, we have a settings tab. As I mentioned, you will need a Google Maps API key, and we paste that one in here. On this cell right here, we can enter what you reimburse per mile. I've got 65 cents. It can be more or less. Also, we have a non-reimbursable distance. Now, if you want to reimburse for all the miles, that's not a problem. You can just set this to zero. But in this case, I'm going to say, you know what, the first 3 miles, I don't reimburse. I only reimburse only if you drive in addition to those miles. There is an option here to avoid toll roads, and whether we want this in metric system or miles. For our Canadian friends or European friends, would be kilometers. In US or Britain would be miles. In this case, I'll just leave this at miles. Once we've set that up, let's actually be a little bit generous. We're going to be paying $1.15 per mile. So then all I gotta do, I go back to my trips page, I click on the calculate button, and the tool, as you can see, will automatically calculate our distances, our reimbursable distance. Again, as we talked about, this trip that the employee had to drive was 24 miles and 24.75 miles, but because the first 3 miles are not reimbursed, he'll only be reimbursed for $21.75. And if we were to multiply that by our reimbursement per mile account, that will end up to $25.01, and that's what I owe the employee for this specific trip. Again, I can put here a date, and I can put a trip purpose. But it really should be as simple as that. If you need one of these tools, make sure you download the single version option. And if you have multiple users for this, make sure you download and purchase the multi-user license. But it should really be as easy as that. If I can help, or if you've got any questions, feel free to reach out. My phone number, my email are on the description there, and also on the website. and there's a link to download this at the end of this this video, or at the end of the beginning of the description. And thank you very much for watching, and till next time.